Bonsoir, mesdames et messieurs. Merci beaucoup d'être parmi nous ce soir pour ce concert exceptionnel dans cette magnifique église. I don't think there's a more perfect place in Montreal to welcome the organist of Westminster Abbey than the Church of St. Andrew and St. Paul. Je suis très heureux d'accueillir mon proche ami James O'Donnell à Montréal pour la toute première fois. Mais l'événement me fait aussi un peu triste parce que ce n'était pas l'entremise de Peter Partridge que James et moi sont devenus des amis. When Peter and I started making initial plans for this concert last summer, I, of course, had no idea that he would no longer be with us to enjoy the music and a visit from his close friend James tonight. His death was so sudden and unexpected that it still seems a bit hard to believe. We are touched and humbled that Peter's widow Janet and son Peter are here with us this evening, along with several of Peter's close friends. Thank you all so much for coming. Peter avait un joie de vivre incroyable, et il était un administrateur dévoué et généreux depuis nombreuses années. Chaque fois qu'il venait à Montréal pour les réunions du conseil, il me donnait le défi de trouver un restaurant nouveau à essayer. Au moins 6 fois par année, pendant 6 ans, nous avons mangé ensemble, souvent avec ses amis Wayne Riddle, John Grew et des autres, sans aucune répétition de restaurant. Heureux que Montréal ait un nombre quasi infini de bons restos, mais malheureux qu'il y ait tant de restaurants que je ne pourrais plus essayer avec lui. In the past few months, I've been honored to attend several memorials and tributes to Peter in Toronto and St. Catharines, and most recently at Westminster Abbey, where James was an incredibly gracious host to me and several of Peter's relatives and close friends. Pete Jr. and I remarked on these occasions that the only person missing at any of these parties was Peter himself, and I think the same could be said tonight. I'm sure he'll be here with us in spirit through James' music, and I thank you all once again for coming. Merci beaucoup et bon concert.
I won't attempt any French, so if you don't mind, I will speak entirely in English. But I'm very honored to be here to play this concert dedicated to the memory of my dear friend Peter Partridge. I'm going to say just a brief word of introduction about the music and then play the concert, if that's okay. Firstly, I'm going to play a coronation march by William Walton, Alban Scepter, which was composed for the coronation of Queen Elizabeth II, which was held in Westminster Abbey in June 1953. And this was originally scored very opulently for full orchestra, complete with marvelous percussion effects and harps and what have you. Very soon after the coronation, Sir William Mackay, the organist of Westminster Abbey, who was the director of music for the coronation, transcribed it for organ, and I'm going to play that version tonight. And there's a personal connection, actually, with Peter, because William Mackay was Peter's boss at Westminster Abbey when Peter was there as assistant organist in the early 1960s. So he knew Sir William very well and had a great admiration for him. So I thought it would be nice to begin the concert with that. Then I'm going to go and play the Partite de Versi on Zeigeglücksete Exekutik by Bach. This is an early work. It's a set of variations on the chorale Zeigeglücksete. And you can hear that in the middle point, the pedals begin. And we think this is probably because Bach returned to the piece later on and then wrote a final set of variations, continuing the earlier ones with pedal. So there's a mixture of styles. But I think it just goes to show how, in the hands of a master, even very simple material, musical material, the chorale tune that it's based on, can be turned into a masterpiece. It's a creative masterpiece, and each individual variation has great character, and of course the organ is able to emphasize that with the different sounds used for each variation. Then I'm going to play one of Vienne's most wonderful pieces, the Clair de Lune, the Moonlight, from one of the suites of the pièce Organist of Fontaisie. Vienne was organist for many years of Notre Dame Cathedral in Paris, a very prolific composer and a very influential teacher. And he was one of these composers who helped to get the organ out of the realm of liturgy and worship and into the more general realm. But he was interested in mysticism, in impressionism, in poetry, in mythology, and all these kind of things. He brought these into his organ pieces in various ways. And in this piece, you can hear the very poetic use of a solo flute stop, evoking the falling of moonlight. And it's a most marvelous and evocative piece. Finally, I'm going to play a piece by one of Vienne's students and colleagues and friends, Maurice de Rufflet, who was also an organist working in Paris. He was the organist at the Church of Saint-Étienne-du-Mont on the left bank of Paris for many, many years, and a great player. Unlike Vienne, though, he was not a prolific composer. He was a perfectionist and wrote very, very little music. But of the music he wrote, which is all of extremely high quality, this suite for organ, Opus 5, is one of the greatest pieces. It's quite a dark piece in some ways, but it's very poetic. The second movement particularly has got a lovely, poignant, poetic feel to it. And the final, famous toccata, is extraordinary and full of energy and quite an astonishing tour de force. I do hope that you will enjoy this concert, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much.
Thank you.